This video explains how to use AEMC's DataView data analysis software to view real-time measurement data from an AEMC power and energy logger. This instrument, commonly called the PEL, provides all essential functions for logging power and energy data from most electrical power networks in use today across the world, measuring and recording a wide variety of parameters. All PEL data is recorded and stored in accordance with user-selected configuration settings. The PEL product family includes two instruments, models 102 and 103. The main difference between these two is that the model 103 features an LCD display screen, while the model 102 does not. Both models can be connected to a PC through the DataView PEL control panel to configure the instrument, download data, and create reports. The control panel can also display data currently being measured by the connected instrument in real time. Before you begin, DataView with the PEL control panel must be installed on your PC. Your PEL must also be connected to the PC through USB, Bluetooth, or a LAN network. The AEMC YouTube channel provides instructional videos that can help guide you through installing DataView and connecting your AEMC instrument to your PC. To view PEL real-time measurement data, open the PEL control panel by clicking its icon on your desktop. When the control panel interface opens, check the navigation frame to ensure that the instrument is listed under PEL Network and that it is currently connected, indicated by a green check mark. If so, click the plus sign next to the instrument's name to display two folders named Recorded Sessions and Real-Time Data. Click the Real-Time Data folder. The data frame now displays real-time measurements from the PEL. When the distribution system currently under measurement is AC, four buttons appear at the top of the data frame. These buttons do not appear when measuring DC systems. RMS displays root mean square channels, including RMS, THD, and Crest factor. Power displays power channels, including PQS, partial energy, total energy, and others. Harmonics displays harmonics channels. Phasor displays the phasor diagram for the distribution system currently under measurement. Notice that the data frame continuously updates to reflect the latest measurements sent from the instrument. Data appears in both tabular and graphic format. For example, the top part of the harmonics display includes a table of harmonics values. The variables listed in this table depend on the type of distribution system. The parameters shown here are for a three-phase, four-wire system. Other distribution systems display different values. Below the table are two rows of buttons that determine which data is displayed in the accompanying graph. The first row selects the harmonics to display. Choices are 1 through 50, 1 through 25, 1 through 15, odd harmonics only, even harmonics only, or the third multiple of odd harmonics. The second row of buttons select the channels to display, including all channels, phase-to-phase voltage, phase-to-neutral voltage, current, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, and neutral. As with the table, the graph continuously updates as it receives data from the instrument. Note that you can change the colors that represent each value in the graph. For example, for the phase 2 graph, both the voltage and the current parameters are displayed in the same color. To help distinguish between these two measurements, we'll change the color that represents voltage. To do this, click Tools in the Control Panel menu bar, and then click Colors. The Display Colors menu appears. This menu lists each parameter measured by the PEL, along with its associated color. To change the color for phase 2 voltage, highlight this value. A down arrow icon appears to the right of the parameter's assigned color. Click this down arrow, select a new color from the displayed palette, then click OK. The graph now displays phase 2 voltage measurements in the selected color. This concludes our introduction to viewing PEL real-time data in the DataView control panel. Be sure to check our YouTube channel for additional instructional videos explaining how you can use DataView features with AEMC instruments.